Hey, it's me, Tiffany. Welcome to my channel where I share all things pregnancy, postpartum, and motherhood related. I am a certified birth and postpartum doula, so that means I support women and their families on their journey from conception to postpartum. If you haven't had a chance yet, please check out my website at www.nurturebytiff.com, where you can check out my doula services that are offered. You can check out my childbirth education courses, and you can check out my merch. So this video I'm going to share with you all today comes out of right up the street from us in Fayette County. So Memphis is known as Shelby County. And then so in Fayette County is right up the street. We had an unfortunate event where right before graduation, three teenage girls decided to indulge in some extracurricular activities, and the outcome was not so great. So I'm going to share the clip with you and come back and I'll talk about it.
The first reporter to share the heartbreaking story of 16-year-old Alyssa Thorne. Tonight, she continues our coverage from Fayette County.
Family says 16-year-old Alyssa Thorne died here inside a car at Fayetteville High School of a possible drug overdose. Her father says earlier that day she warned him students were bringing drugs to school.
I just want to give her a hug and a kiss and I love her.
This photo is a memory Mark Thorne is holding on to. He's desperately wanting to dance with his daughter, 16-year-old Alyssa Thorne, who he says was the victim of a possible drug overdose outside Fayetteville High School.
It's the hardest thing I think any man could go through. Especially over some dope that some kid brought to school.
According to the Fayette County Sheriff's Office, a little after 4:30 Tuesday, two teen girls were found unresponsive in the parking lot. A third teen was taken to the hospital, but has since been released. All the girls ranging from 16 to 17. Thorne says he video chatted with Alyssa earlier that morning.
Because you were telling me that the boy was bringing cocaine to school, and I was telling her, don't mess with that. I don't want to have to bury you. That was my exact words to her, and then that night she's dead.
Thorne says the autopsy is still pending, but he believes his daughter died from cocaine laced with fentanyl and wants those who gave her the lethal drugs held responsible.
She said, Daddy, I love you. I won't do it. I don't like the way it does me.
Days before the overdose, he says Alyssa, who lived at a foster home, was upset on Mother's Day.
Smokes a little weed. You know, she's been through a lot with her mom abandoned her, you know, 3 years back.
He's sending this message to other teens battling drug abuse and peer pressure.
It's not worth the pain with or without the drugs. Look now, my daughter's dead at 16, and it could be anybody. She had a lot of hopes and dreams, man, but now it's just a dream.
Alyssa's family has started a GoFundMe to pay for funeral costs. Tomorrow, there will be a balloon release here at the school at 5 o'clock to honor the young victims. Now reporting in Fayette County, Bria Jones, WREG News Channel 3.
So that was a story, and that is super devastating because, you know, if I'm not mistaken, I don't know if all of them were getting ready to graduate or some of them were getting ready to graduate, but at any rate, to hear that a classmate, a student, your child has overdosed on something, you know, a substance or whatever, is horrific. You know what I'm saying? This fentanyl thing is crazy. Like, it seemed like they're lacing everything with that, you know. It's sad that one of the girls, because the father came forward and gave out her information, her name and all of that, and it's just so sad that we have young children, you know, young children that are going through so many things in their lives that they feel like their only escape is to have some type of recreational drug, you know what I'm saying, cocaine. I know we got a lot of people, you know, that smoke weed or, you know, things like that, but you, and they got this whole popping pills and, you know what I'm saying, all that type of stuff, but you have to be careful out here because you don't know, you know what I'm saying, what somebody is giving you, what somebody's lacing your drugs with, you know what I'm saying. I'm not condoning drug use, but I'm just saying I know that we have people out here who are doing drugs for whatever reason to, you know, escape reality or escape things that they're going through. And it's just, it's sad that, you know, people are putting additives in things that, you know, end up taking people's lives. And two of the victims, you know, two of the three have passed away, and the third person is actually now being charged with, you know, doing this. So you have to be careful who you hang with. You have to be careful who you call your friends. I don't know if the other little girl knew that it had fentanyl in it or, you know, whatever. But by the same token, man, you got to be careful. I don't care if it's a freaking cookie, a brownie, a slice of cake. You know what I'm saying? You got to be careful when you're taking stuff from people, because you don't know what people have put in your food. You don't know what people have put in your drink. You know, I tell my kids all the time, don't take nothing from nobody. I don't care if you want a box of Nerds. Don't take it. You know what I'm saying? Because you just don't know, you know. And it's sad, like the father mentioned, you know, he said his daughter had a lot of hopes and dreams. She was going through a rough time, and, you know, just going through a rough time, and she was just doing what she needed to do to try to, you know, make it through and maintain. And it's really unfortunate. Like I said, I hate that our youth and people in general are having to turn to drugs to try to cope and help them through things in life. Because, I mean, I know life is stressful. I know life is hard. And, you know, a lot of us have things that we're battling. A lot of us have, you know, demons that we're trying to fight. And we all have coping mechanisms. You know what I'm saying? We'll use drugs. We'll use, you know, alcohol. You know, some people use shopping. Some people use sex, you know, to try to cope with things that are going on in their lives. And that's not always, well, it's not the healthiest, you know what I'm saying, option, the healthiest thing to do. You know, it's so easy to sit back and judge, and people say, oh, well, she shouldn't have been doing drugs anyway, or she shouldn't have been doing this, and such wouldn't have happened. But you don't know the things that people are going through. And I feel like you should not judge anyone until you walked in their shoes and you know what they're dealing with. I just hate that this is, you know, this happened. You know, our youth is struggling with a lot of things, and I'm just, you know, praying for the family, both of the families. The information on the second victim has not been, you know, released as of yet, but I'm just praying for the families. And I you know, I hope that people can learn a lesson from this. I hope that people are more careful, you know, with their activities and things that they do. But I just wanted to get on here and share this really quickly. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.